Kid Morning. First off, I must say, in Trinidad and Tobago football, the reputation of Jablote, you know, is well known. You know, all they know fly by night team, right, and all they are accustomed to success. But I must also say, second place last year in the Pro League was a surprise to most fans and most pundits and commentators and announcers like myself. Tell me, what you intend to do to go one better?
Well, Sawa Jablote was out of the football for 3 years, so I know that is a surprise when we came back because of financial issues. But we planned well when we were preparing to come back, and that is a success in 3 years' time that we were able to pick up the second position. Also, we have added new, as years continue to go, we'll add new players where we'll be able to be successful and maintain it.
Right, new players. That is a big thing this year. We've seen a lot of action on the transfer market and on the registration market. New people coming in and people changing teams. You know, if you not to let out your secrets, but tell me what we can expect by Jablote this year with regards to personnel.
Yeah, well, we have added Willis Plaza coming from Alanzia in El Salvador. We have Kisto. He came from Canada. And we have a few Jamaicans that will add to the to gain it right.
Jablote took the big step in last season with Common Community. You all established yourself down in Barataria and so forth. Tell me if you expect to continue that, one, and what was the response of the community, you know, in that big move?
Yes, our Jablote, we take the opportunity to come Barataria. The community was silent. They are proud that we made the move to come in Barataria, and they are waiting for the new season, 2016-17 season, so that they can come out and give us their full support. You know, they pass, they see us training, they want to know exactly what's taking place. And I think last year was just a tease. I think this new season, the crowd will be bigger, and it will do well for the community. Well, you know, as always, you know, you had the W connection, the Central, and you had Defence Force. Defence Force is like a family, and they know each other. So these three teams will always be a challenge to Sawa Jablote.
And you know, Keith Jeffrey, you are man, no stranger to Trinidad and Tobago football. You are around long time, you know, a player, now coach and so forth, at every level, you know, even at the national level. Tell me now your feelings on the Pro League.
Well, I think the Pro League, because the challenge in the Pro League is more financial. The people at the top, which includes the club, we need to market the Pro League a lot better. If you look at the secondary school league, they're getting the job done, and they are amateurs. We at the professional level have to dig deep, go into the private sector and see what they could do. Not only for football, but for sports, because you look back at the Rio Olympics and the cries finance outside the state, you know, where the private sector would come in. So it goes to all sporting discipline where we ask in the private sector to come forward and do more for the sport.